Howdy folks, and welcome back once more to Let's Play Secret of the Silver Blades. Today, the ascent of the dungeon continues. Before that, though, I'm gonna come in here, unequip this mace plus 4. We're gonna give this to Brunhilde. The mace plus 3 is going to Devon, and these will enable our other melees to more effectively fight the golems, which we are more than likely going to be fighting probably a couple more times in here. So at least now Devon and Brunhilde will be able to fight them. I would rather them have it than Goldleaf, because realistically Goldleaf just kind of hangs around and heals people. You hear screams from the south. You see stairs down to the north. Okay. Can we just bash this? Yeah. I'm waiting. There's got to be one of these that's just, like, full of, like, horrible things. A prisoner screams as he's stretched over a rack. What do you do? We'll rescue him. Swell yells, "The torture chamber is an illusion! We are almost surrounded by the enemy!" Evil laughter echoes through the dungeon. Alright. What do we got? Dryders? So it was brought to my attention that Dryders in 1st edition, according to Monster Manual 2, have magic resistance of 15%, so that would explain why our spells occasionally bounce off of them and don't do anything. It's not that they're like just making their saves and the game's being jank as fuck, it's that they're just immune to magic because drow, the fuckers. Son of a bitch. Spell throwing shits. I have Rove Delay, and Chunk can go introduce himself here. Oh, Vala. God, she is nasty as fuck. Everybody's just so encumbered from all the coins. Except for Brunhilde, who just gives no fucks. Because she has, like, fire giant strength or whatever. Good XP. Plus 4 arrows. Let's detect. Let's see what we got here. Bracers are gonna be our regular stuff. Our stuff's just like assorted goodies. Sure, why not? Go ahead and save. Ooh, I dig the wall texture change. The image of a raving madman forms before you. Very good, you're doing well. I'd like to introduce you to some of my special pets. Pyrohydras loom over you. Evil laughter echoes through the dungeon. What do? We'll fight them. Pyrohydras are hydras, but they breathe fire because fuck you. Did it say these things are 12-headed? Holy shit. Yeah, the 12-headed pyrohiders. Damn. These are some chonky lads here. Can I? Alright, we're gonna miss that pyrohider on the left, but it's almost dead. Okay with that. That was a pretty sad fireball, Devon. Only 3 attacks. Surprised they didn't give him like the full spread of 12, because fuck you, that's why. I think this'll hit all of them. Okay, and they're softened up enough that I'm pretty confident in the melee's abilities to just hack through them now. Oh, there's the breath. Okay, so their breath weapons tentatively aren't too bad. Good to know. Do you have? You don't have any heals left. Shit. Oh, we're actually running low on healing in general. Okay. Good to know. Again, again, good XP and some treasure. We got... It's all magical. Jesus. Okay, take it all. I would love to find a teleporter. That's what I'm kind of holding out for here. I want to give this to Goldleaf, and I want to give this to Rove. Because Rove can cast Read Magic, and Goldleaf can just look at this. Oh, it has a heal spell on it. Wonderful. Cast that on Vala. Nice. What else do we have? Some Raised Dead. Cause serious wounds and slay living. Alright, sure. Rove, cast, read magic. What is this? Detect invisibility, confusion, charm monsters. That is a shitbox of a scroll. Ah, I hate it. So are these all just here to, like, troll me? I think they are. I'm thankful that they don't really seem to be, like, throwing a bunch of just, like, trash encounters in here in the hallways. Can they teleport, you fucks? Party has detected a trap. What do you do? Disarm it. Chunk. Chunk gains XP. Yay! We discovered something. Alright. Alright, a bunch of stuff. Is it magic? We don't know. Chunk. Go ahead and just take it all. Oh, take the jewelry. There we go. Oh, I'm sure this is gonna be another bastard of a fight up here if I can't answer the riddle. The image of a raving madman farts before you. You can answer my riddle or fight my warders. I'll try to answer. Two little words will gain entrance to the next level. You must keep it after giving it. What is it? Your word. The image disappears in a puff of smoke. Hey, look at that! I fucking answered a riddle, because occasionally I'm not a complete idiot. And that actually leveled up two people. That leveled both Brunhilde and Chunk. So Brunhilde gained 3 hit points, and her Thaco is 9. Chunk gained 2 hit points, and his Thaco is now 11. More importantly, though, it healed them both, which I am... infinitely, infinitely thankful for. Didn't need to turn on search. I do, however, want to save. Some might say that being able to level up like that mid-quest and heal is cheating. Those people would not be wrong. Also, I don't care. Disarm it. Chunk, you have disarmed the trap. Yeah, go Chunk. Okay. I'm glad that they've got, like, some trap. The dwarf detects an illusionary wall to the west. I'm glad that they do have, like, some traps in here, just, like, enough that it's worth kind of having a thief with you. A trap door opens beneath your feet. Damn it, Chunk! One job. One job and you botched it. Thankfully, there aren't any fucking trash mobs in the hallways. Makes it a little bit less annoying. Mostly just a waste of time. Okay. See, I don't like this room. I am gonna go back, though. I want to see what's in this other section of the dungeon. Anything. A mage heard some basilisks out the door. What do we do? I guess we're fighting. Shit. No! Okay. Try for the fireball. Don't you fucking do it! You sons of bitches. Should hit, I think, all of them. Or not, because I guess reasons. Just in case. Now that mage won't be able to cast. Oh! Petrification, son. I'm like So glad that nobody is getting petrified here. Okay, mage is down. But I shouldn't say nobody's getting petrified. The things that are getting petrified are the things that I want to get petrified. Okay, that wasn't too bad. I mean, any fight with gazers sucks, obviously, but we got lucky and it was manageable. Actually, I don't want Chunk to take things. I think he's full. We'll just take it all. Oh, okay, I guess we're leaving it. Because it's all just junk that we already have a bunch of. You have found a map to this level you take and recorded as journal entry 68. Let's see here. Is this just, like, legit? This is, alright, so this is legit. Just a map of what we've already seen. However, according to this map, through this door is a transporter that I hope takes us back to town. Oh, Brabjus Day. Oh. Okay, note this down. Dungeon. I think it was like level 8, maybe? Thankfully, it numbers my map notes, so I know, like, on this map which is town, because town is 1, and then just each sequential one is, like, further and further into the game. Oh, man. We're gonna have, like, so much money. It's like an inventory is just full of garbage that I don't even, like, it's like some top shelf Monty Hall bullshit right here. Another suit of plate, +3, shield, +3. I think that plate's going to swell. Actually, I think he's the only one of the melees left that doesn't already have it. Fucking -7. Swell, go home, you're a tank. Okay, quarterstaff +3. It's a shame that's two-handed. I would actually give that to Gold Leaf. I would love to get, like, a stack of darts of, like, the hornet's nest or something. That would be wonderful. I think that's everything, isn't it? I don't think Devon had any. Devon just has so much shit on him. Holy hell. Alright, so I'm actually gonna sell this longsword. Gold Leaf. You can equip that mace +2. Alright, so the shield +3. And you've got a shield +3. You've got a shield +1. Gold Leaf, you have a shield +1. I'm gonna give that to Gold Leaf. Her AC is the worst in the party, which is saying something, considering Rove. But Rove has that Cloak of Displacement, so his, like, I mean, Rove's AC is nuts. He has a -3 AC. That is crazy for a wizard, but all the same, like, holy shit. All right, so how much money is just, like, laying around here? Not too much, actually. Well, I'll have Brunhilde take as much of this as she can. Can she just... Yeah, Brunhilde can just carry it all and gives no fucks about anything. Because strong. I fucking love it. Actually, no. We're good. We're good. Let's come back over here. Before we go in, we will encamp, and we have to memorize all of our everything again, because high-action gameplay. I mean, we are blowing through, like, a lot of spells in here. These are some pretty chunky fights, but still at the same time, it's like, holy shit. I'm pretty proud of that silence spell we got off in the last fight. That worked pretty well. Okay. Oh, and Vala has apparently leveled. Because she needs to be more powerful. I think she might actually be hitting... I think she might actually be hitting level cap. Level 15 fighter. Is that... That might be level cap. I can't remember. I thought everybody capped at 14 except for, like, thieves. No, 15 is the cap. Yeah, so she just capped as a fighter. Thieves cap at 18. Everybody else caps at 15. Alright. Well, shit. I mean, I guess... Sure. Go ahead and camp fix everybody. Go ahead and save. I don't want to quit quite yet. Go back in. Get out of here, mouse cursor. Nobody wants you on screen. See how many more of these levels we can punch through while we're still doing pretty good here. I'm pretty glad I came back and checked that side hallway. I'm actually gonna... note that down so that if I need to flee in the future, we can. Oh my god, movement being janky. The dwarf detects an illusionary wall to the east. That was actually on the map. I just want to explore everything just in case there's things in any of these. Assume these are basically like holding cells or something. I dig these wall textures with, like, the I don't even know what that's supposed to be. Like, they're super simple, but they look good. We'll try to answer. Two little words will gain entrance to the next level. It's light as a feather, but you can't hold it for 10 minutes. What is it? Ah, your breath. Man. That level gold leaf. Holy, like, these riddles answering these things are a lot of XP. She gained extra second, third, and fourth level spells. Not heal, but alright. Stairs down. The Gyno Sphinx sits surrounded by an aura of magic. What do you do? We'll parlay. If you want information, you must have a tithe. Alright, we'll give you a tithe. What is it? She takes 10% of your money. I don't think we, like, hardly have any money. You must have the amulet to get the keys. The first key is located in the southwest corner of this level. The answer to the next riddle is river, and the second key is located 3 levels above. Go now, and we are pushed out. Alright. I mean, that was helpful. Did it take... Okay, so that actually does look like it took some of our gems and jewelry. I don't care. Because, like, we have more money than we know what to do with, but alright. Worth it. Evil laughter echoes through the dungeon. The image of a raving madman will answer. One word, it says. Give me one word in answer to my riddle. Has a mouth but does not speak. Has a bed but never sleeps. What is it? River. Okay. Alright, we're not gonna go up yet because there's apparently a thing on this level that we need. Nobody leveled from that one. Swell is getting close, though. Umber Hulks burst from the walls. Alright. That doesn't make a lot of sense given the layout of this level, but okay. Get in there, Gold Leaf. Yeah! Gold Leaf hit something! Had to happen sooner or later, I guess. She is like... She's such a bad fighter. Just such a bad, bad fighter. Okay. Can I place this? Yes. Good fireball. Very good fireball. The reason I had Devon delay was because I wanted to see how Rove's fireball did before I had him do anything. If Rove only did like a little damage with that fireball, I was gonna have Devon also fireball, but instead, face was wrecked, so I think we're okay. I want a magic missile. This thing has one hit point left, so we might as well put it on its ass. The door to the southwest glows faintly around the edges. Surely there's nothing horrible in here. Oh. Search. Okay. Well, it did say we needed the amulet to find the key. Or whatever, so maybe we can't. Maybe, like, there is a thing in there, but we can't get it yet because we maybe need the amulet. Door closed. Need amulet? Six, three, Sphinx. Need amulet, four keys, one key, one south, one three levels up. River. Fucking love map notes! Ugh! Like, it's just. Let me draw on a map and or write on a map in a dungeon crawler, and it immediately elevates your crawler by at least 2 points. You hear maniacal laughter coming from the second door on the east wall. The image of a raving madman forms before you. He is hanging his head in sorrow, tears course down his cheeks. Swell recognizes that the image is hiding something. You discover a trap behind it. Chunk disarm it. Chunk gained XP. The image disperses in a puff of smoke. Okay, and we get some goodies. A mage scroll and a mace. Brunhilde, take the mace. Rove, the scroll. Sure. I'm just gonna leave search on while we're in here, I think, because it seems like all of the encounters we're bumping into are, like, planned encounters? Let's leave. Is it just... They're waiting for you! Nice! Nice! Good touch! I was gonna say, like, can we just, like, go in and leave and go in and leave? That's pretty good. I respect that. Oh, bad fireball. Very bad. Lightning bolt him, I guess. This should hit them both? Yeah, okay. A little better. Still kinda poor damage, but enough. And then we have Vala to mop up here. Okay. See, now I gotta go back, because there's one room. What's in here? No, in here. Nothing. Okay. Gotta make sure, you know. Can't trust anything. You see a mage contemplating some papers. He looks up and starts casting. What do you do? He completes his cast and disappears in a flash of light. You take the paper he was reading and record it as journal entry 62. Oh, let's see here. 62. Our flaming creatures are claiming the ice quite quickly now. The dungeon is open to just below the castle, where ice is much more resistant. Thankfully, we have discovered a second door upward. This leads along a winding tunnel into a glacial crevasse. It was undoubtedly an old escape tunnel hidden by the Dreadlord. We have seen no sign of adventurers, but disturbances have been reported in the lower levels. As a precaution, we have thawed out the purple worms. This will slow us down, but will provide much-needed defense. Oh no. Purple worms are very nasty. A low moan of despair fills the chamber as you enter. I didn't actually mean to go in that door, but okay. Medusa are ready for you. One of them emits a moan that sounds piteous in its desperate agony. Oh, evil laughter echoes through the dungeon. The Medusa attack. So have we finally found the one that's going to be full of things that try to murder me? Oh, that is so tempting to lightning bolt Come on, Rove. You need to get. Ah, goddamn it! Hit them both. Hey. Oh, sorry, Chunk. Didn't mean to get you too, buddy. Sorry, these are gonna be the ones full of critters. I do have to say that I am impressed by the dev's restraint in not just having monsters in like 90% of these, because I absolutely would. The image of a raving madman forms before you. You can answer my riddle or fight my warders. I'll try to answer. One word, it says, give me one word to answer my riddle. Runs smoother than any rhyme, loves to fall but cannot climb. What is it? Water. Oh man, I'm so good. This is a tiny level. I kind of dig that they're doing these smaller levels of the dungeon and having like multiple levels of the dungeon on one map, like it's kind of clever. The image of a raving madman forms before you, evil laughter echoes through the dungeon. Striders and Entons are dividing some loot. They are surrounded by the bodies of unlucky adventurers. What do you do? Well, of course, attack. I like experience points. Is this the first time we've seen Entons? I don't think it is, but it might be. Oh, good fireball. Oh, there's one Drider left. We'll magic missile him down, see if we can. There we go. Alright, and this is just work for the melees. Scroll and play mail, sure. And we'll take the jewelry and the gems, sure. Never enough. The image of a raving madman forms before you. No matter, it giggles. I have other pets to stop you. Yeah. You see Medusa and Etten's in the distance. We'll wait. If prepared to attack, we will fight. I wait until they get to me so that my melees are within murdering range, because it's very important that they are. Okay, the threats are taken care of. They're worth, we'll try Stinking Cloud. Stinking Cloud hasn't been getting as much use as it should, damn it. It's a good spell. I'll Ice Storm these guys. I'm not gonna waste a fireball on them. I don't think it's worth it. Fala going full killing spree ending as per protocol. Man, it's like, it's crazy to me how effective our melees are. Like, this is not how melee fighters are in newer editions of D&D, usually. It's pretty refreshing being like, oh, you know, we can just murder everything. The Gyno Sphinx is being held in this cell. She will trade information for her freedom. What will you do? We will, of course, free her. She gives us a map to where to find the second key. You take it and record it on journal entry 32. Okay, so this is a map of the fourth level. Okay. Where's my mouse? There's my mouse. See. Key on level 4. I'm looking at this map that she gave us. There's also another teleport back to town. She leaves. Alright, sure. So this is why we check all the prison cells. The image of a raving madman, we will answer. One word, give me one word. You break it if you even name it. What is it? Silence. Alright. Another level awaits. The dungeon has taken on a deathly silence. And on that note, I think we are going to go ahead and camp and call an episode. So as per usual, folks, thank you for watching. I hope you had a good time, and I will see you next time when adventure continues. Until then. Hey, you made it to the end. Nice. If you had a good time, check out one of these other series, see if you like them. Drop a like, comment, or subscribe if you'd like to support the channel, via the machine and all that. As always, thanks for watching.